Good morning and welcome to Inspiring Women for the Women's Centre. I'm here this morning with Donna, but we're going to introduce her in just a few minutes. The Inspiring Women's program has been sponsored by Vicky Simpson Real Estate at Professionals. Vicky is actually doing extremely well, but as like all agents in the Wairarapa, looking for new listings. There's people out there wanting to buy and there's not enough houses for sale. There's such a demand in Marsden and the rest of the Wairarapa at the moment. So take the time and think, if you're looking at selling your house, looking at buying a house, contact Vicky Simpson at Professional Real Estates. I'm dressed this morning by Dress for Success. Thank you to everybody that voted on the spotty dress. It's really quite nice and it makes me look very slim. Thank you. It's always a benefit when something makes you look slim. Donna, welcome.
Good morning.
Donna's the the Tiafina Cameron Community House Coordinator, which is actually a very busy role you have down there.
It's crazy some days, as you know.
That's good. So the thing is that 2 days are never the same down at Tiafina.
So true.
I spend Wednesday morning down at Tiafina doing our craft group down there, and I'm down there on a Thursday morning doing cooking courses. So there's different people coming in different days. Tiafina offers so much to the community down there. It's just amazing on what they've got. But who can come to Tiafina, Donna?
Anybody. Anybody can come through those doors, and we invite people to come. You know, it's not just necessarily the east side. So we'd like to see lots of people.
I'm just checking here because we don't have anything coming up at the moment, so I'm just checking and making sure. Donna, can you tell me what number your mic is, please? Right, we'll just continue on. So all our numbers are coming up now a lot better, so that's really good. So I must have just clicked into recording. These things are here to challenge us. Donna, tell us, what do you get out of being at the Cameron Community House?
I get great satisfaction in watching people develop skills that they already have but just didn't realise, and then watching them, you know, further their education, be it going to UCOL, getting a job, just, you know, watching them get their wings and build their confidence up. It's amazing.
It's actually a house that it's got a homely feel. So you're talking about looking at getting a new place built for you. And the biggest discussion is how it feels like a home. Tell us, how does it feel like a home down there?
So when I first went there, you know, it had a bit of a clinical feel to it. We had chairs in the lounge rather than lounge suites. So I went to our favourite shop, the Salvation Army, and bought a leather lounge suite. And with that, we were able to transform the community house into a homely feel, and that's what I believe connects the people. You know, they come in, they don't feel like they're in a office situation, and so it helps them relax and makes good friendships, you know.
Some of the discussions that are held in the lounge and out in the garage area where you have your crafts is actually quite interesting. People come and they feel comfortable enough to talk about different things. Talk about some of the things that are discussed.
Yeah. So, we get a lot discussed, as you well know. Probably more, it gives them the opportunity to open up about things that are troubling them. And in a group situation, you come up with resolutions. And if we can't, then, you know, we do refer them on if it's, you know, needed. But sometimes it's just that general sit round and talk, and something that's troubling them doesn't feel quite so bad once they've shared it.
And I think what I like down there too is that once they share something, they also then discuss it. Absolutely. And there's different ideas.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden somebody says, but I've been through that.
Absolutely. And that's really good. That's part of, you know, them being able to open up and understand that, you know, if somebody said to them, hell, I know how you feel, you know, I've been through that. It does make you feel better because you're not alone.
It takes that isolation away, doesn't it?
Yep.
Absolutely. And that's the important part, is a lot of people feel isolated, whether they're going through grief, whether they're going through financial difficulty, whether they're just even going through mental health. It can actually mean quite a bit of isolation for them.
Yeah, yeah. And that's what we encourage. If you're stuck at home and you're feeling low, come and join us. We'll make you laugh.
One day Donna was down there, and the Mia Lynn came down and joined us, and Mia Lynn went off and answered a phone call and came back and looked at Donna, and all of a sudden she went, Donna, you've got my glasses on. And we'd actually set Donna up with her scarf and her glasses. And then a couple of minutes later, she looks around at Donna and she goes, you've got my scarf on as well. So it's those sorts of things that just makes, to somebody else, they think, oh, what a bit of silly hilarity. But for everybody else, it made them feel like Lynn is actually part of everybody else. Absolutely. That comes in. Made her welcomed into the area. And just by having a good old giggle, it was actually really good. And we know with Lynn, if we put some food in front of her and a drink, you know, she's there with us for a long time chatting.
She totally enjoys coming down.
And that's
we enjoy having her.
That's really good, because, you know, a lot of people feel that because they're from the block, people don't see them as people of Marsden, but in fact actually I enjoy coming down, because you never know what's ahead of you.
It's so true.
Yeah, we have lots of laugh. We have some very sad days, but what I see is actually a team of people that group together and actually help each other.
That's right, and that's what we really push for. You know, it's about a connection of community. You know, we've had some really sad things happen. And, you know, it's about going out there and saying, right, well, you live here in this community. It's up to you to look after your community people, you know, your neighbours. Look out for them. If they're going through troubled times, go and see if they're okay. Go and have a cuppa with them or invite them to yours. You know, it's just checking up on each other. And I've really pushed for that over the 6 years I've been there.
That's actually really good, because like we had our power out yesterday. It's getting dressed and my light went out. You know, it's unusual for a lamp to go out, you know, the light blow while it's on. Went down to make the toast and the toaster wouldn't go down. I was cursing because brand new toaster wouldn't go down. To find actually half our house had actually gone with power. And next minute the two neighbours are over texting or calling in, have you got power? So it was really good to know that we're in that community. But for people that are at the block, it's also good, because there's people living alone, or they might be raising children alone. It's just, even couples down there, it's good to know if they need help, they can go to each other.
There's no, you know, like where I live, we have a great connection with our neighbours. And it is like a little community. And I think there's so many places around where nobody has a clue what's going on for their neighbours. You know, they have no idea what dilemmas they're facing every day. And I just think, you know, people just need to stop and say, you know, hi, how's your day? Take the time to listen and take the time to ask. You know, yesterday was a prime example of the connectedness. I got a knock at the door, and there was a young girl with two of her children. And she said, oh, I love your library on your fence, but it's chocker and we're just bringing in another pile of books. Can I leave them with you so that you can put them in your library? Now, that's fantastic. She could have taken those books and, you know, left again. But it was that library has brought a connection to our community. You know, where people aren't scared to come in and knock on your door and say, hey, look, I want to donate books. You know, I think it's important.
You know, community is important. And in our busy lives, we forget about community, you know. You've got neighbourhood support out there working hard to try and connect communities together. One time, There was never anything like that around because communities automatically did it because everybody knew who was around. Around by us, we've just had 120 new houses gone. There's no way you can keep up with who's there because they're in a short time and they're gone again.
Absolutely.
You know, and people move so often now.
Yep.
So it's also good for people to know that actually, you know, to be in the block, and you hear people say, I've been brought up in the block, I moved away and I'm coming back to the block.
Yeah.
They talk of the block as such fondness.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of people who think of the block in a different negative way.
Yeah.
But the block is, it's like anywhere you live in any city.
Yeah.
There's good and there's bad right next door to each other. And seeing some of the people down there that are actually saying, yes, I do need help. And yes, I do need to be out doing something different.
Yeah.
To be able to come to Cameron Community House is really fantastic. You know, Cameron Community House has so much to offer, more than this. But what we're going to do right now is we're going to actually take a break because we're going to be doing a lot more talking about what's coming up. And we're going to listen to Hayley Westenra, River of Dreams.
Lying in your arms, we'll dream
Welcome back again to The Inspiring Woman. We've got our Easter breakfast on Friday the 3rd of April, 7 to 9 a.m. So we've also got a fun thing, and I'm sure the girls down at Tiafina would love doing this. It's actually an Easter bonnet competition. Now this is thanks to Lynn from Food Bank, who came in her curlers and her shower cap to our pink ribbon breakfast last year. She started something. So Frances is making some wonderful homemade chocolates as a prize. So it's $20 a ticket. All you have to do is give me a call or email me at wireapperwoman@extra.co.nz to book your ticket. Make sure you do, because I tell you what, it's going to be another fun morning. Welcome back, Donna.
Welcome, thank you.
Donna, we're talking about courses down at Tiafina. You have got an amazing amount of courses on. Do you want to start talking about some of the ones that you've got down there?
So on a Monday, we have Literacy Aotearoa with Sharon Perry from, obviously, Literacy Aotearoa. And that's been running since I've been there, so nearly 6 years. And even I've done some of the courses. You know, they teach you so much about money, what kind of money person you are, makes you more aware. Apparently I'm a thrill seeker, which sounds
right. When you've seen Donna at a secondhand shop, I can see what you mean by that, and craft shop. I can actually see that quite clearly.
So it was very interesting to put a label to my shopping. We also have a Te Reo class, which is on a Wednesday night. And on a Wednesday night, we have a youth group. And that, you know, that's a really awesome thing for our youth. You know, they've done all sorts of good things. They've painted murals at the alleyways.
Yep.
They've been on a trip down south. You know?
So last year they went to Nelson, wasn't it?
Yes.
So they went down to Nelson and they had set things. And they'd actually fundraise.
Yeah.
They set what they wanted to do and they went and did it. And they've got really great team leaders as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And so they also did hangis for $8 a hangi. You know, they're out there doing it and it's really good teaching. We have dressmaking and mending with Carol on a Tuesday, and so she's teaching the girls how to use patterns, and they're making kind of like bloomers, pants, or a skirt. And also, you know, there's the available machines and mending.
So you have one room in the house that's set up purely to sewing, don't you?
Yeah, definitely. Quilting out of recycled materials, that's on a Thursday with Chris. That's gone off with a bang. Everybody's enjoying that. Apparently they're going to finish a cushion this Thursday. We have cooking with yourself, basic cooking on a Thursday morning. So we're sort of overlapping with programs and it keeps the place humming along. Lots of laughter in different rooms. We also have Lisa, who does our crocheting, and this term she's doing it with a little bit of a twist, and that's to teach them how to crochet and how to access patterns, how to save patterns, how to save pictures and put up on Ravelry what they've done, what they've made. We also are a volunteer for the Red Cross, and last year we did with yourself, we combined doing knitting, which was donated back to the Red Cross and went out into our own community. So not everything goes overseas, as people would believe. It does come back in our winter warmer boxes for our own community, which is fantastic. We also have the availability of computers for anybody that wants to use them. We have kids after school coming in and using them. Thursday night we have Man Up and Legacy. Now on the 14th of March they've organised a block party, 300 free hangi, bouncy castles, two of them, and this will be held at Tia Whina. So, you know, it'll be fantastic, and I'm going to be walking the streets putting flyers in people's letterboxes. There'll be a sausage sizzle and lots more, and there'll also be some of the team sharing, you know, just what Man Up and Legacy is about, and the connection for men and women to be able to share and work through. It can be addiction, abuse, sexual abuse, verbal abuse, anything.
I think that's what's needed, because everybody knows there's that going on in the community. So be able to go and talk to somebody else and know what it's like is absolutely amazing.
Sharing.
I met the coordinator the other day and I was really impressed with him.
Yeah, no, it's fantastic. They've done an awesome job, and they've been there probably 4 years now, you know, and it does fluctuate. One week they might have one person, and next week they might have 15, and it just depends. And there's no cost, there's no pressure. You can go and sit and just sit and listen to other people share, you know. It's fantastic.
That's really good. What else have you got down there? So we've done different things last year, like junk journal.
We did our junk journals. That was amazing. Still addictive. Some of them, I actually had a phone call from one of our volunteers this morning, and she said, I've still got to finish my journal. So, you know, we will help you do that, as it's a memory that she really needed to pass on to somebody. What else did we do last year?
There's did a lot of crocheting. I enjoyed the crocheting. I unfortunately can't get there on the crocheting day.
I even learnt to read patterns. And, you know, I've gone from making granny squares all my life to being able to actually follow a pattern.
So both you and I have done the sweet pea trellis pattern.
Oh, that was beautiful,
and
wasn't
that's
it?
Just amazing. And I've just finished another rug, which is actually a ripple, which actually goes up and down. So it takes quite a bit. That took quite a bit of concentration.
It does.
But one. Lisa's got a chance of being able to get this wool in, and it comes in a bundle in a nice little bag, organza bag, and you sit there, and before you know it, that organza bag's empty and you got yourself a beautiful rug.
Absolutely. I've just started the hydrangea and it's so pretty, and I've ordered the dahlia. So
I've tried the dahlia with some of my leftover bits. I don't know whether I'm overly keen on doing it. I think it's gorgeous done, but you know, it's I sat down the other day and did a bag, because just by gaining the confidence to do something different, because I was like you, Peggy Squares.
Yeah.
And that's all I'd done in my life. And I used to do one big one, so you didn't have to join them.
Absolutely.
Now I'm doing one with bits and pieces, where it actually, you join it as you go. So, you know, there's things that you can be learning.
Yeah.
And, you know, you just remember, you don't need to be living down in the block. You can come down.
Absolutely.
And we've got a young girl that started joining our cross stitch course, who's just come into town, and it's great because straight away she's made connections.
Yeah,
didn't turn up last week and everybody's like, where is she? So that's really good. You know, that's what the important thing is about Cameron Community House, is actually coming in and getting involved.
Well, it's nice to have Sandy Hayes from the Rimahunga Lions join us. She's an avid cross stitcher. She's done some amazing work.
And she's really good because she's very quiet and she encourages the ladies, you know.
Yes.
We've got some that are doing it first time ever. We tried them on 16 count. Didn't work. Went into the cross stitch. Now on 6 count. So I'd never worked with 6 count before. It's like a big canvas, but it's an Ada. And just seeing them come along and actually getting their designs, you know, beforehand they couldn't even find the hole. But now to actually be there with their pattern, blank canvas or blank Ada, and they're actually making something, is actually amazing.
It is. It's clever, actually, to watch.
But I think what I see through the courses is actually helping and sharing with each other.
Yes.
They don't just sit there and do their own thing. There's one's got a pattern, so a couple others will try the pattern. There's been one down there with a knitting pattern recently, and I think everybody's tried the knitting pattern, and it's not a good knitting pattern at all. Nobody's been able to complete this jersey. One's tried for months, and I'm like, I wouldn't have had the patience. No. I would have thrown it away a couple of nights. But it just goes to show on how they're committed to actually do things for the community and give back. And I think giving back is an important thing to install in people, that you just can't take.
No.
You've got to give back.
And isn't it funny, you know, like they're enjoying what they do, and every program that we run, people say, well, that's crafts, you know, that's fun, it's a hobby. It's not. Everything we run has an element of numeracy and literacy. And so while they're having fun, they're learning to count and they have to write things down. It's, you know, all of that stuff. If I said to you, right, today you're coming and you're going to do maths, you're going to go, uh-uh. If they're sitting following a pattern, they've got to count.
It's even recipes, making sure they've got the right quantities.
Yes, knowing what the measurements are. Because if
they don't do the right quantities, they've got to know how to read the abbreviations for quantities. You know, cooking is one of the best ones for doing it. And it's actually interesting because, you know, as you know, Donna, I worked with a young guy last year. Beginning of the year, he didn't know what some of the abbreviations were, let alone how to measure out stuff. Yes. By the end of the year, he was setting what he was cooking, and he was doing it all himself, all the preparation himself. Yeah. So it just goes to show you were actually instilling some amazing life skills into them.
Yes, yeah. And it obviously pays off because, you know, over the year, last year, the end of the year before and last year, we had 11 volunteers go into paid work. I mean, that's huge. Where else would you get that? This year, we've already got one of our volunteers going back to UCOL at 58 to finish a degree. You know, it's amazing. If you give them the confidence and tell them, you know, you can do anything you want.
I have lots of conversations down there, and I talk about what courses, and I know, Donna, you've been doing some study as well, and we bring up the conversation quite a bit about study and how we are processing through our study. And it's actually interesting because I've now got a couple that are helping me with my next one, which is my New Zealand CAT, which is, for those ones that don't understand, is New Zealand Certificate in Adult Tertiary Training. They're like, how can we help you out? So they feel like they're connected with me and they're part of my course by actually just being there and coming to the courses. And I had to have a supervisor in as part of my course the other day, and Tracy from Reap House came in, and everybody wanted to have a talk to Tracy because she's like part of the team as well. So, you know, it just goes to show that you only need to come down there for a short time. And you're welcomed in.
Yeah.
You're then shown. They love showing you what they're doing.
Absolutely.
You know, seeing these ones. So what we do on a Thursday is we do the cooking, and then people come in that are doing the patchwork, come in and get the lunch from them, and hearing them talk about how they made it, talking about the measurements, the ingredients, working with ingredients they've never worked with before.
Yeah.
Is always something new. So we had a lady in the other day that was cooking, and she'd never ever cooked. Her husband always cooked. And she made sponge roll. She helped make sponge roll. And she was just over the moon. So it just goes to show you're never too old to learn.
Absolutely. That's so true. You know, like I'm thinking of, you watch them and they do, we have the garage sale. You know, you go out there and you see their confidence, even those dealing with the public, you know, learning to work with money, learning to be sociable to people, learning to be like a shopkeeper, really. So those skills that they've learnt through the garage sale, I just think, you know, it's a win-win, isn't it, the garage sale, for the community, for our volunteers. And if people keep dropping rubbish off, as we had last week, it becomes an issue. And I believe we've got another lot this weekend.
So remember, guys, this is actually a community organisation, not a dump.
Yeah.
If you can't dump your stuff, then come and ask on how you can. Come and ask for help. Just don't dump your rubbish off. Because at the end of the day, I know you might have to get out of your house by a certain time and you're like, where to go to? But, you know, come down and there's people that can help, that can you obviously were able to get it to one place. You were only a corner away from the dump. This organisation is a not-for-profit organisation. It's there for the community, and if you keep dumping rubbish, it's going to take away funding that actually should be used to for bring your community together.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And, you know, I mean, we can help if you're stuck. There are means and ways of dealing with this. So, yeah, if you know of anybody that's doing this or going to do it, please tell them to come and see me before you drop a trailer load of stuff off that isn't saleable, you know, and help your community, whether you belong there or not.
Because I wouldn't like to see the garage sale go, because I must admit, I poke around in there.
Yep.
But what it gives your volunteers, there's not another opportunity to be a volunteer and handling money like that.
Yeah.
To learn how to actually present.
But it's not even that. As much as that is important, it's giving to the community. The community are able to come in and buy cheap stuff, you know, for their whare. Clothes for their children, you know?
I'm always poking around in there. I must admit, I'm a bit of a... Adonna's trained me up well on a second-hand shop.
Queen of op shops.
You're the queen, I'm the princess.
But if you say so.
But it's like getting down there and finding stuff. And, you know, they've got a deal coming up at the end of the month where you come in and it's just...
A koha.
Yeah. And you can walk out with as much as you need.
Yeah.
So remember, guys, if you're looking for toasters, jugs, there's crockery, there's
linen,
clothes, knickknacks, toys, you name it.
Yeah.
You know, there's things down there. So for a koha, that's an amazing that you can actually change your kids' wardrobe around.
You know, cheap enough.
Nice and cheap.
Yep.
And they're all pre-loved clothes anyhow.
Yeah. Yeah. It is. And Nan, to be fair, does a wonderful job in that garage. She's always cleaning. Her and Nanny Ann, always folding up and cleaning. So, yeah. So any donations, we greatly appreciate them when we're open.
And also they've got to be resaleable.
Yes.
You know, at the end of the day, resaleable.
That's
if you've got stuff that needs to be dumped, then contact Donna and she'll help you organise that. You know, at the end of the day, it's also about respecting your community, because your community is missing out because they have to organise.
Well,
so the other day you had a guy come in and...
If you wouldn't buy it.
There was a guy come in the other day that picked up a load of stuff and took it down to the dump. You know, it was great to see somebody in the community step up and actually help out.
Yeah. And that's the art of the Facebook page. You know, we post something and everybody, you know, they take it to heart. It offends them that this is happening to a place that does so much good for our community. And, you know, they all want to offer to help, and it is. That's how it's connected. Via the house, via Facebook. It's amazing.
And of course, you also got some really good partnerships with Salvation Army and St. John's. So you're looking at bringing stuff down that's saleable, that people need in the area.
Yeah.
So that's actually a really good opportunity. That it's not just people, that stuff that people donated. Donna's always searching for something in there, I tell you. You're always looking in her car. It's loaded full of stuff that she's gone around and found. And she knows what people need in the community. And if you're really stuck on something and it's not in the garage sale, talk to Donna, because I'm sure she'll find it somewhere in some op shop.
Oh, yes. We're pretty good at being able to source what is needed. It's actually a real buzz to be able to help people, you know.
And that's it. You know, it's some days I walk into your house and it's like, where's Donna? And there's a line sitting in the lounge of who's next for Donna. It's like, just about take a number and wait for Donna, because people do come, and it's good that they've got a place to be able to come and express their concerns, come and ask for help. You do work in income advocacy as well, as well as court.
Yes.
So, you know, there's Donna's a multitasking woman at the best of times. She's trying to have a breakfast, a cuppa, and talk to several people at a time. But that's Cameron Community House, because the community's coming in and joining.
We just roll with it. We just have to. It's the quick and the dead. If you come in, make yourself a drink. Otherwise, you'll die of thirst.
Otherwise, the other 10 people that are waiting for dinner already got their drinks. Yes. And they're sitting comfortable. But, you know, in that time of waiting, they actually also start talking.
Yes.
And it's because they're not in a waiting room, they're in a lounge. It makes that homely feel. And we'll talk about that homely feel again of it. But even your courses are done in a homely feel.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's really important. So there's a couple of things that I find really important is that the courses at TFN are very friendly. They've actually got really good tutors. Yes, I'm one of them. But also Donna sources different tutors from different places, and we're going to talk about that very shortly. But we're going to go to Hayley Westenrower again, and we're going to go to Hine e Hine.
Kiri mai ki taku mā, āku koe chaku e whakachuku, me ngā ori tō mui, me ngā wāri.
Welcome back. That was actually really nice music. I was just saying to Donna while we're sitting here talking that they actually really suited the house. I just love Hayley Westenra. I think she's so calming and, you know, it just brought in the culture of the house as well. Donna, we're going to come back and talk to you. You know, there's lots of things that are going on other than courses down there as well, and the garage sale. You've also got food parcels. Would you like to explain what happens with the food parcels?
So 3 days a week, we have Michelle, who orders the food parcels Monday, Wednesdays and Fridays, and then she will go down at 12 o'clock and pick them up. Sometimes she has to deliver them to their homes if they don't have a vehicle, and otherwise they come to the house to pick up. So you've actually got to be part of Te Awhina Cameron Community House. You've got to have some connection to us for us to be able to order you a food parcel like any other agency. And we prefer that you have your order in for the food bank before 11:30, so it gives them time to make the parcels up. You know, some days we have 7-9 orders. Well, that's just for us, you know, that's not the other organisations.
So what time are the volunteers there on those days so that they can ring in early?
So Michelle arrives at 9, and, you know, you can ring, people text me, and I pass that on, or we have Facebook messages. You know, there are ways of contacting us, or you call into the house and we will order those for you. After 3, we then will refer you to Connecting Communities, to a budget advisory, because obviously something's going wrong for you and you may need a bit of support, help. To be able to, you know, we understand that, you know, you may have a large power bill, phone bill, or children need something.
It's amazing even how a new washing machine or something like
that can
actually cause issues within the budget.
Yeah, and food always seems to be the last thing. And when you've got a family, that's, you know, it's very hard. Very hard. I know that the schools support, you know, with Breakfast Club, and, you know, if you haven't got food for your kids for lunch, Lakeview School in Makoda will provide. All you have to do is let somebody know. There's no need to keep your kids home from school.
And I think that's important.
And don't be ashamed either.
That's important. There's these connections out there in the community. And if you feel comfortable with Donna, then she can lead you into these connections
Absolutely.
As well.
I can go and do it for you. You know, if you're too embarrassed to do this, I'll do it for you. Mm. We just don't want to see our children going hungry. Or mum and dad.
Exactly. So mum and dad's usually the last ones that get fed in the household.
Yeah.
But when you look at those food parcels now, you know, it's so great that we've got Why Waste involved as well, because see, veggies come in those parcels, meat, different treats come in there. I know the women's centre love doing bake-offs. Just before Christmas, we did a bake-off down at Te Awhina with our girls. And we did date loaves and Christmas fruit muffins. And it's really good because we did it a day that didn't come back into the community. And we put tags on them to say they were made by Te Awhina and the women's centre. So people in other parts of the areas, you know, got to see that it's actually giving back.
It is. It is. And it's nice to be able to support Lynn and the food bank. You know, they are volunteers. They do a wonderful job. Wonderful job. And, you know, I just think, you know, if you're coming to Te Awhina Cameron Community House, just drop in a tin or a packet of something that we can give back to food bank, you know.
Let's I like saying to people them. That have come in to get their food parcels and they go, oh, well, if that doesn't actually suit you, leave it behind and let somebody else enjoy it.
Yes, yes.
You know, definitely. When I take food parcels in, because the women seem to do food parcels as well, always go and help them unpack it just to see what's in the food parcel and say to them, you know, would you use this? If you don't know how to use this, where would you use it? So it's actually good to talk to them and see where they're going to, because a lot of the time, is that they don't actually know how to put veggies together. Yes. They don't know how to do that. So that's why it's important that if they're not sure, they can also connect with cooking courses.
That's right.
Or you can connect them to the community centre cooking courses as well.
That's right. They're out there, so, you know, there's a lot of help and support for that now. And, you know, like I was thinking about it earlier, you know, how things, people don't know their neighbours and stuff. And, you know, a lot of people have to work. And they go to work early and they come home late. And then everybody's so busy. And grandparents are still working. So these skills aren't being passed on. So that's what we're there for. You, me, that
the life
is what
skills
we're
are
here.
So important. Absolutely. Some of the basic life skills is so important. You know, we just go and do something for fun. You know, like you do the Kamatua dinners down there.
Yep.
And everybody gets in and cooks. You know, we did soup one time.
Yep.
You did chicken and salad another time. You know, it's actually the younger ones giving back to the older ones in the community as well, which is really important.
And respecting them, you know, and they love it. We made knee rugs for them last year. Also, we're going to be looking at running a housie, a fun housie. So Nora Nene's helping me set that up. So keep an eye out. We'll be letting you know via Facebook and maybe some flyers that we'll be having some fun housey once a week.
Sounds a lot of fun. And of course for them, it's they don't have to travel into town for it. So it's nice and close.
So I wear another hat as well. I also help our tenants, trust house tenants, and we do income related rent. If they have problems, they can come to me and we can, you know, if I can't fix it, then we go on to the housing officers. So I'm sort of in the between. You know, if you're struggling with your rent and stuff, I can be an advocate for you. Let's get it sorted. You know, come and pop in and see me if you're having problems. And I'll step alongside you and no matter what. And I like to, every person that I've walked with, I want an outcome. You know, and 9 times out of 10 we get good outcomes. It's just knowing your rights
and it's really important because with the tenancies ones is actually getting that tenancy related rent down as well.
Yes.
So that's actually, how does that work out per the wages?
So it's 25% of your income, and it's basically, you know, our tenants are on low income, so 95% of our tenants are entitled to this.
That's brilliant.
You know,
yeah, it's a great
it
opportunity.
It does make a difference.
It makes a huge difference, especially when you're trying to juggle everything.
Yeah.
And I think it's really important too, because once you walk with them through that, you put them onto connecting communities and they walk through on their budget side.
That's right.
But it's getting that connection in and, you know, bring that trust across to another organisation.
Yes.
Donna works with so many different organisations down there. She wears many hats with Trust House and the Tiafina. But there's a lot of other groups that you work closely with, Donna.
So the Salvation Army have been brilliant. They've supported us right from the day I started. When they get excess stock, they have passed it on to us so that we are able to make some money or just to help out our community. Whaiora have been absolutely amazing. They've come in and, you know, we've had times where they've been able to, the nurses have come in, they've connected with our volunteers and people that come in from the community and help them access dental care, swimming and other
walking
groups, you know, just to help support them. Hopefully with our new build we'll come along a specific room and we will be able to have them more frequently. And Te Hauora, we've had wonderful support with them. We go to FGCs, we can refer for counselling, addiction, anything. Pathways is the same. We've, you know, access to pathways, Reap House.
So a lot of these ones that you're hearing, you're sort of thinking, what are those? Well, actually, if you're not sure what they are and you're not sure what you need, then Donna's the one to come to, because it's like a one-stop shop.
Yeah.
One-stop shop. You can come down and get things. Donna, it's been great talking to you this morning.
Thank
we could have talked
Thank
for a
you.
Lot longer.
Thank you for having me. It's been wonderful.
It's, it's when you get into these different areas. When I started at the Women's Centre, I came down and I met Donna. And we started talking and she was like, oh my gosh, we need people down here helping. And I've really enjoyed my time down there. I've got some really great friends. I've got a great friend, Madonna. But, you know, people that you actually now used to look at you in the community now come up, give you a big hug. You know, to wonderful Vicky who comes across with a tray of scones to say thank you for the smallest of things. It is a community that actually gives so much and it's really wonderful.
Well, it's a pleasure to be there.
It is. It is a real pleasure. But we need to wind up and we've got Vonnie's been back at work this month and we've got some really fantastic programs coming up, which she's got her support groups back. So they're actually also really important. They make a connection. So there's two support groups. There's actually just a support group, which is actually for everybody to come in and talk to, sit down, have a coffee. They organise different things, like they're doing chocolates and all those sorts of things. Then there's the Older Woman Network, and that's actually a lot of the group of people that isolated kids have moved on, perhaps marriage is gone, husband's passed on, and it's actually an opportunity for them to come and talk about where they are in their life at the moment and support each other. It's brilliant. Great. It's great. So check out our Facebook. It's really, really good to go through our Facebook. So we've got a couple of big things coming up. Don't forget our Easter bonnets with the Easter breakfast. The challenge is out there. Let's see on who can make a really fantastic hat. And always check our Facebook. We've got one thing I haven't put on is we're actually doing flowers with icing on a nail. So it's a specialised nail that you do for icing and you can make roses and all that sort of thing. I did some the other day, but I did it with butter icing, do it with royal icing, they harden. Then in June we're going to do a naked cake course and you bring your roses back in and you put them on your naked cake and there you go, you've got a celebration cake. Nice and easy. If you want to know what a naked cake is, check our Facebook out, because I tell you what, that's going to be coming up soon. The icing one's on there, so that's on the 27th of March. So if you need to book soon, because I need to order the kits. So for $40, you get a kit that you can walk away and go and make roses and bits and pieces. We're going to be doing some videos that night as well, so I'm going to be learning with you, because I haven't had time to do this. But I'm going to sign off now, because this week has gone shares and it's a very special week for us. I've got a husband that's been 40 years in the Golden Shares as a volunteer giving back to the community, and our son follow along's right behind him, and this year Stephen, after 40 years, is getting his 25 year service badge. And don't tell Jacob, thank goodness this is, he's not going to hear it beforehand, as he's actually getting his 10-year service badge as well at 14. From the time he's been able to walk and stand up and look at a sheep, he's been in those backyards working. So to everybody that's involved in the Golden Shares, have a wonderful week. By the time you hear this, it would have gone. But to community, to Tiafina Cameron Community House, I really enjoy being down there, and thank you for having me.
Thanks,
to everybody else, goodbye.
Bye.